A number of isolated mannequins are attempting to have a conversation with each other. They can't move. They watch from behind a screen. They want a connection. But they struggle to find one. They're arranged into groups, or arrangements of familiar and unfamiliars. The young people on the outside try to make contact. They try to find something in common, something to communicate over. They keep making eye contact, hoping for a connection. They struggle to find something fixed, something they can all view at once. They stare at the glass until something happens. They act familiar with the people on the other side, hoping to be recognized. It's hard to find a shared point of contact. They try looking through the screen at the same point. Think about your eye contact. Think about your body language. They're arranged into groups or arrangements of familiar and unfamiliars. Chosen and not. The young people on the outside look in and wonder. They all try to find something in common, something to connect over, and something to combust over. In this place we used to call home, the walls now feel rotten, blistered and rough, like aging skin. The walls sag and take on new forms. If you stare at them long enough, they might come alive. Containers for lives lived, and windows into manipulated worlds. Their neighbours are having to move because their houses have become obsolete. Their neighbours don't stop moving. Their neighbours are unfixed. Perpetually displaced by the crumbling object that contains them. Do you understand me? It's the place we used to live. Our homes are going obsolescent and cold. Windows spill open and let in strangers. Stare at them long enough and they might become familiar. Our homes have become overmade, overdetermined. Containers for isolated bodies. Attempting to communicate with each other through screens and walls, intimate moments of miscommunication. A number of fragmented and dismembered bodies try to have a conversation with each other. Their words are now blistered, lumpy and old. They emerge with force and rupture the surface before evaporating into abstract shapes and half-remembered thoughts. Is our community obsolescent, made redundant by the strive for more progressive forms? Left behind in lumpy, crumbling containers. Communities of vapor and mist, obsolescent arguments and degraded memories, enhanced memories and new things to fight for. I walk the street and my body doesn't belong here. My body feels bulky, heavy, obvious. They don't want me to linger here, there, anywhere. Got to keep moving, blending into the flow as much as possible. At home I used to be still, but now it also propels me to keep moving. Passing through, never stopping anywhere long enough to feel a connection. The view is heavy, but it fails to weigh me down. A number of isolated bodies attempt to have a conversation with each other from disparate points. In the country and across the globe, behind their screens, their faces are lit up and their bodies rendered still. Do our homes create intimacy or isolation? Core networks, social isolation and new media, real life, real news, real voices. We are instruments for communication. Communities of waste and hope.
Great design is timeless, but the future always beckons. Opening new doors to new possibilities.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live, and you can tell everybody.
We're obsessed about security. For them, every screen is meant to be touched, and web pages are meant to be scribbled on and shared. They'll expect their devices to listen to them.
You're from the 70s.